Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Key Silius here on the channel. Today, we're going to be returning as Nazeebo, part of my little bit of redemption plan here for the last game that I did with Nazeebo. It wasn't a bad game, but as everyone was quick to point out, along with myself in the commentary, I was very rusty at the time because it's been a while since I played Nazeebo, up to that point anyway. But as I've been saying in the last couple of episodes with the Nova and Alarak episode yesterday, I have been playing more Nazeebo. He's still one of my favorite characters. He was the second hero I've ever gotten a Master Skin with, and maybe the third. Actually, I know he was the third, because the first two were Illidan and then Kael'thas, respectively. But the build I'm going to be doing today is going to be very different than the last build that you saw. It's a build that I've been playing with nonstop, really, and I like it. It's a lot of fun. It is a little bit challenging, especially going up against so much burst DPS. Here's our team today, by the way. It's going to be Lucio, Valyra, Illidan, Avala, and Nazeebo, Duncan Sand going up against Chromie, Nova, Vala, Greymane, and Uther. No warriors on either team, so there we go on that. No, by the way, I should also mention that no one in this game was in a party, so this is just all pure 100%. Solo Q Silius here. Level 1, gonna go for Thing of the Deep, which is gonna increase the range of all my basic abilities by 20%. Well, 17%, but it might as well be 20%. But this is the build I've been running, offline. And whenever I say offline, by the way, I mean in games that I'm not recording. This is a much more simplified Nazeebo build. It sort of harkens back to the time back when, like, I used to be pretty decent at Nazeebo, which was basically, like, in the early part of Technical Alpha. And what I like about it is that you can play it like a standard right-click build, like any other hero, except you have all the benefits of being, basically being Nazeebo. You don't have to really worry too much about the, about landing or not landing your spiders. Uther's gonna come after me, I don't know why he wants to do this. We're gonna activate the spiders here. Uther, you're not paying attention, Uther. What were you thinking, Uther? I don't really know what was going on with that, but the increased basic attack range and all the ability range is going to allow us to poke from a distance. I do know that Nova is right there. And yeah, there she is. That's right, Nova, I saw you go in there. Don't think I didn't. I actually, the other day, I got accused of, I wish I had taken a screenshot of it, but I got accused of hacking the other day because I was spotting enemies who were supposedly stealth. I wish I had that sort of skill. Like, that would be pretty neat. I do know that Nova is, like, right here. So I'm gonna keep an eye on the Shimmer there. She's gonna move up top towards this middle brush line. We'll have to wait and find out if she stays there. That's not the real, no, that is the real Nova. My magic flows through the My spider's gonna stay on top of her here, and I'm just gonna go right after her as well. Try not to get hit by the tower. I was hit by the tower. Thankfully, Lucio was coming this way. I was not able to kill Nova, unfortunately, but that's all right. With Lucio here, it should allow me to get back my HP pretty quickly. But I think a lot of people are going to like this build, especially considering, you know, how... I don't want to say I played bad the last time you saw Nazeebo. I'm not including the Jesse game, by the way, because I played much better during that that game with Jesse, as I was Nazeebo. But... It was just rusty. I mean, that's the best way I can describe it. I was just super duper rusty. But hey, at least I admitted it. I'm not going to try to mince words here and say, oh yeah, you know, well, I'll just have an off day. No. Level 4 gonna be going for Blood Ritual, which is going to give me 1.95% of my HP and MP or mana back. Whenever something is affected by my poisoning attacks, if they die, that's going to restore a little bit of mana and a little bit of health to me here, as you're going to see that start to jump up more and more often whenever the creep does go down. I saw Chromie coming up here. I did see that the dragon's wrath. No, there she is. I am going to get the heck on out of dodge here. I will make sure that we keep Lucio safe, however. Got tagged by the sandblast there. I know that Nova's going to be looking for the snipe. There she is, right there. So both teams trading evenly there. I think we actually did take we took I think most of the shots on the tower. Nice job, Valyra. Unfortunately for Valyra, she ended up cheap-shotting the wrong Nova. But one thing I love about this, and one thing I love about other builds like this, as everyone knows on other heroes especially, is the self-sustainability that I love. When it comes to being able to basically take care of myself from a mana and from an HP standpoint, where it makes things a lot less hectic, and it also keeps you it keeps you focused and it keeps you focused and keeps you in the lane. So what I mean by that is that you don't have to worry too much about saying, oh, well, you know, I've got to worry about my HP. I mean, you always have to worry about your HP, but it's not going to be your main, it's not going to be your main prerogative in a build like this, because of the simple fact is that Nazebo should have almost full HP nonstop as long as I have some sort of way to kill enemies. There's the Garrote there by a Valir. Unfortunately, was not enough to stop Uther from getting away. I even saw that time trap coming as well. So this Uther player is playing a little bit too bold here. He might be a newer player as well. That's fine. I'll happily take the free kills. Level 7 here, going to be going for Dead Rush, which is going to make the zombie wall deal more damage, but more importantly, it's also going to give us some more creep to play with on our side of the wall. I do see that Nova is right there. I do not want to get followed up here. I don't want to get Hammer of Justice and then followed up with a snipe by Nova. So I'm going to take the long way around as we're going to head on down here to the Crocodile Temple. And by that, I mean the Jackal Temple. It goes Crocodile, Serpent, and then Jackal. So basically what I was waiting for was for Nova to come back out of here. I didn't actually notice she had followed me that way. I'm gonna drop the zombie wall. I'm gonna trap Lucio in there briefly. I wanted to make sure we got the kill there on Uther though, which we were able to do. There we go. Instead of the double kill. Apologies to Lucio. Hopefully you have more faith in me that I was not going to leave my support stuck inside of the zombie wall. You can retract the zombie wall if you just tap a W again before it goes for its full duration. That silence is gonna really screw over Chromie. Nice job with the reverb there by Lucio. Throw out the zombie wall here to run a little bit of interference on top of Greymane, and we are able to get there. No one actually controls the Jackal Temple right now. Of course, we do have to be very cautious of Chromie, because Chromie does possess the ability to kill Nazebo very easily. I do know that Nova is right there. I see her. There she is. That is the real Nova, by the way. Actually, no, it's not the real Nova. She's right there. So unfortunately, I am out of mana here. We did lose Valira. But Vala sort of stumbling on in here is not exactly what you want to do. And down goes Vala. I've got my spiders on the real Nova as well. And I'm going to stay on top of Nova, which I was able to do. I'm going to go after Chromie now. Oh, you're telling me that that didn't land. We got two shots left here on the Jackal Temple. And Lucio and I were able to get it. Going to probably end up killing me, though, unless Lucio, he is able to crossfade me out of here. Illidan coming on in here with the hunt. Thank you, Illidan. Level 10, going to be going for Gargantuan, which is basically going to give us one-on-one fighting ability. But unfortunately, I've got no more mana, and I danced back and forth around long enough for Chromie to land the Dragon's Breath on me. So really unfortunate that I didn't have enough mana there, because I would have easily killed Greymane and Uther, unless he got Divine Shielded. Should not have died there. I should have went back after getting saved by Illidan, but I wanted to turn around and try and possibly secure a couple kills there, so definitely should not have died. I'm going to go up top to help push back the top lane here. After 7 minutes, it's 10-8, a very close game right now. One thing I love about Nazebo is his ability to be able to pretty much do everything that a team needs him to. He can be a lane pusher, he can be a brawler, he can be, well, he can't really be support, but he can do everything else besides supporting. And if you want a good counter to someone like Asmodan or someone like even Murky or Abathur, Nazebo is going to be your guy, because he is going to be able to shut down lanes very, very quickly. And especially given his passive, again, having Voodoo Ritual just ticking nonstop and taking down enemy creep is essential at taking over the lanes again. I was gonna see if I could fake out Chromie there, make her go after me instead of Vala. Here comes the rest of the enemy team. I do know that Nova is sitting right in there, because I saw her on the map. So we're not going to overextend too much here. Illidan and Valir are both waiting in the grass over here. I don't know why Valir decided to go for that when she could have easily just gotten a cheap shot. Soon they shall bask in my glory. A cheap shot would have easily killed Greymane. Do have to be careful though. Do not want to get followed up from a stun here by Uther from a rain of vengeance from Vala. Gonna go tap the fountain real quick. Just to tap off. And by tap off, I mean top off. Here we go again. This time the Crocodile Temple is going to be active up in the top. And again, a very back and forth close game so far. We're just going to go after the top here just because, I mean, we've got a hand. We don't really need the entire team up here. The enemy team doing a good job catching back up in this game right now. They've taken down a fort advantage as well. I'm curious to see where Nova is at right now. I don't actually see her anywhere near me. The enemy team's taking down that. I'm going to go down to the bot lane and go defend that. Level 13 here. I'm going to be going for Superstition, which is basically going to be a passive that reduces the ability damage that Nazebo takes in trading out some physical resistance, some armor, basically. So he trades spell armor for armor. Just think of it that way. That's the best way I can describe it. The enemy team even got the boss. Now, that's not something that we should have allowed happen. For a second there, I thought I saw Nova right here, but apparently she's not there. Illidan and I shutting down this this push really quickly. There's Nova. I actually got her inside of the zombie wall as well. I'm going to throw the spiders over there. Look how much damage the zombies are doing to Nova. I'm going to grab the gargantuan here as well and help us DPS down the boss mob. And the zombies are going to do a very nice job and help me out with that as well. Getting pushed by the Cyclone. The Cyclone won't get away from me, man. Bad time for the zombie wall there, right as the boss mob was doing his AoE attack. But we were able to basically solo defend here against this boss. Illidan left before the boss even got to the keep, and I was able to stop him from taking too much damage on our bottom keep while we still got a kill on Nova anyway. So that was a pretty good job overall. It should have been way worse had I not... I don't want to make it seem like that I'm the only thing keeping us in this game right now. But if I weren't playing Nazebo, Nazebo is about the only character that I could have done that on. And by that, I mean have effectively shut down the double siege giant push along, comboed with the boss mob, with the skull golem. I mean, there's no way that anyone else would have been able to do that except for Nazebo and maybe Asmodan. But even then, Asmodan would have sort of a tough time taking down a big, bulky, tanky target like the skull golem. So we lost a little out on XP there because most of us were relegated to fighting and trying to recover the lanes here at 11 and a half minutes, 13-9. Not a very kill-heavy game, surprisingly. Considering the team compositions here with all the burst damage on the enemy team, I thought for sure that we were going to have at least 40 deaths by this point. Maybe not 40, that's a little bit of a gross exaggeration, but most of my team's going to the south here. I'm going to stick around in the Serpent Temple, but I'm not going to dismount. Okay, so most of the enemy team looks like they're down below, actually. So I will stay up here and go after the Serpent Temple. Basically, as long as I can. Again, I'm watching the minimap right now with my right eye. I mean, not simultaneously, you know what I mean, though, you freaking nerds up there. Level 16, I'm going to be going for Ring of Poison, which is basically going to make the epicenter of my zombie wall do damage over time, which ticks for a whole lot. Like a whole lot. Yeah, you see the poison there applied. There's the Ring of Poison. If I get an enemy hero caught inside of the zombie wall, that is bad news bears for them. So I was able to get every single shot off with the Serpent Temple, which is pretty darn good considering that we lost the bottom. The Jackal Temple did go the other way here from the for the enemy team. Oh, that's bad news, bears. I was able to get Nova. That is the real Nova. I'm going to get the Gargantuan here first. I'm going to see if I can get the Garg over here as well to help me out. Gargarion. Yeah, Gargarion, where are you? Where are you, Daenerys Targaryen Gargarion? Unfortunately, the Gargoyle is not going ever. There we go. The Gargoyle Gantuan. Look, it doesn't matter. Gargantuan. Just call him Daenerys. If he had gone after Vala, and by the way, I was commanding him to go over there by using the hotkey for my heroic ability. Unfortunately, it was not going to happen, though. He was still fixated on that creep for whatever reason. But you saw how quickly Nova died there. I didn't even truly need to use the Gargantuan. Here comes the Chrono Surge here by Chromie. We are able to get the Siege Giant, and Chromie's not going to be able to get out of there with Valyra and with Vala being there. As you try to get down a strike it down on Dragon's Breath there. We are going to trade basically 3 for 1, which is not too bad. Might even get Luther here, which would be good as well. And the enemy team has a pretty nice push going down bottom. Again, a very, very close game. Luther is forced to use Divine Shield. He is going to probably be able to get away, though, unless Lucio goes over there with Crossfade. And he might be able to take him out. Yeah, there we go. All right, so we ended up catching back up. The boss camp's going to be up in 38 seconds. So we cannot safely take the boss camp right now, unfortunately. When it comes up, I mean, the only person who will be down will basically be the enemy team support. But I'm going to do my due diligence here and push back the bottom lane as much as possible. And again, you see the surge, just a huge boost in the lane from Nazebo. This is just me using basic attacks along with a couple frogs, and that pushes the lane all the way back to their base. Now I do realize that we had frozen them thanks to that engagement that we had again going after Uther, whatever. If you want to do that, I'm gonna let you do that, Nova. Illidan actually went right over the he went over the wall here. I'm gonna use a gargantuan and see if we can help out. Unfortunately, we're not able to save Illidan. I'm gonna get taken down anyway. Probably shouldn't have helped Illidan there. That one, Illidan getting thrown over the gate. We should have just let him go. I thought we'd be a little bit safer there with Lucio using Sound Barrier, but we should not have really stayed there. Honestly, that one's on Illidan. I could have backed off, and I should have just let him die. I wasn't expecting the enemy team to all be right there at the same time. I saw Greymane and I saw Nova, but I didn't see Uther coming back. And on top of that, I didn't see Vala either. They're going for the boss camp right now. And that's in my opinion, that's a pretty big mistake by the enemy team. They shouldn't really be doing the boss camp. They could have taken this temple, but they're going to lose out on that. And what's even better for us is the simple fact that I'm going to be able to shut down this push. Although they do have an exposed core on the bottom. But I will be back up here. Level 20, by the way, I did go for Vile Infection, which is going to basically make me do a lot more damage here with my Voodoo Ritual, which is Nazebo's passive against enemy heroes. And that's a good start there, getting Uther right inside of the zombie wall here. I'm going to activate Gargantuan as well. Gargantuan almost actually killed Uther outright. We do have to be careful of this boss, though. Completely whipped on the zombie wall there. I was trying to stop Vala from getting away, but this boss camp is not going to do anything. There we go. So yeah, they got 8% of the core there. A huge mistake. The enemy team, I do think, could have won the game here on that. Maybe not won the game, but it would have been real close. Apparently I walked into that, I think. Nova completely whipped on the triple tap. She actually hit the wall there. Making sure I give Illidan something to jump back to with friend or foe. Vala going way too ham on that one. Although I might be able to get Vala in there. Vala got stuck inside the zombie wall. Down she goes. I'm going to get back out of here because I can't afford to die. Enemy team now getting cut to pieces by our team. They overextended there trying to follow up on the boss golem, but that didn't work out quite so much. By the way, let me go over Vile Infection real quickly. Upon reaching 150 stacks of Voodoo Ritual, which I've actually been slacking on a whole lot, the damage bonus also now applies to heroes, and it also deals 200% more damage, which is a massive amount of extra damage from the poison. And the enemy team is going to be in a lot of trouble here. They will have a chance to defend one of the temples, but not all of them. Illidan ready to use the hunt. I'm going to go up top because basically I'm the only one who can safely take down one of the temples solo. At least, I mean, one-on-one, 2v1. I mean, I've got Gargantuan. He's ready to go. And if the enemy teams try to jump on this, you know, we're going to be able to shut them down fairly easily. So here we go. If the enemy team is not able to stop both of these temples, it's going to be bad news bears. I'm not going to... I really don't want to leave this. We weren't able to save Valera there. I was able to get Uther inside of the zombie wall. Valera apparently... She looked like she was going to engage there, and I thought that maybe she came out of the... she came out of stealth, but apparently she was not engaging. Now the enemy team's going after Illidan in the Serpent Temple. And Valera gets taken down. Down goes Nova, though. And I'm basically, again, just sitting up here watching watching the minimap. We don't have to worry about the sneak attack of Nova. There we go. So we're able to take down both of the keeps, and here comes a couple rapid fire shots on the core. And the enemy team is not going to be too happy here. 59% left on the core. Yeah, good try. Good try, Greymane. Good try. So we're gonna take down the night camp right now. 28% left on the core. We've got catapults over there, but Chromie is still alive and she's able to defend most of that. Vala's up there as well. What was that? What was that, Lucio? Did you say we are in the groove? Yeah, I guess. So we got that night camp pushing. I'm going to create a huge push up top here, trying to lead with the catapults here. I'm going to try to lead the night camp and the catapults. Oh, there is Nova right there. I saw her coming. She's going up top. She hit a pinning shot on me. Here comes the hunt. The counterattack from me and Illidan here. I'm going to make sure I keep the pressure on Uther while still going after Nova. Nova ended up getting the Divine Shield from Uther, and now Nova's going to die anyway. So that's going to be the game. Uther tried his best, but that's the reason why you want to stay on top of the enemy healer and not go after Nova, especially someone like her who can just drop stealth immediately. Got to be careful of the Dragon's Breath from Chromie. I do not want to get one shot here. Also got to be careful of the time trap. I'm going to go ahead and activate the Gargantuan as well to see if he can lead the charge here with the catapults. We've got three catapults left. We did lose the night camp. Oh, I was able to grab Uther inside of the zombie wall there. That took a lot of damage off his HP. The core sitting at 0%. Going to take the win. Final total, 25-22. Nice job overall. Much better Nazebo game, I think. And, yeah, I'll go ahead and put the build down below. Let me know what you think of this build. It's a lot of fun. Like I said, it's a lot. This is a lot more AA right-click focused than the last build you saw, and I think that a lot of you, if you're having trouble with Nazebo, with the spider build and the zombie build, try this build. It's a lot easier and a lot more fun, in my opinion. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I'll see you all in the next episode. Until then, so long, everybody!